Porn sex versus real sex. What's the difference? I'm Dr. Trish Leigh, let me tell you. We're going to talk about the 7 primary differences in this video, and I've also made an extended version if you'd like to see more aspects that compare and contrast real sex to porn sex. So let's start off with vital parts. Vital parts of porn actors are between 6 and 9 inches long. Yes, we're talking penises. That is not the truth when it comes to real sex. On average, men have penises that are between 5 and 7 inches long. So this is the takeaway that I want you to have, is that we know from the science that pornography consumption decreases self-esteem in men. And the reason is because when you watch porn, whether you know it or not, and I know a lot of men know it, you are also comparing yourself to male porn actors' vital parts. And when you compare yourself, you, who are average, maybe even above average, still are not as large and in charge as a porn actor is. And the reason being is they literally are hired to be there because they have big vital parts, above, way above average sometimes. So in real life, you don't need vital parts that are enormous to have a lovely sexual experience with another real human being who is also having a lovely sexual experience, which moves us along to the next part, is that women on average are not interested in any of the acts that are seen in pornography scenes, not even the extreme acts. And I don't want to mention any here because I always try not to be triggering, but even just what would be considered kind of run-of-the-mill porn in terms of who's in it, the number of people who are in it, the body parts that are being focused on, between 3 and 20%, depending upon the acts that we're talking about, of women have even tried those acts. And that, when that doesn't indicate pleasure, that doesn't indicate interest. 3 to 20%, 3% of women are interested in even remotely trying these acts. So we see those acts, and those that are much worse, including violence and including, I don't even need to tell you, things that women do not enjoy. So here's what I want to tell you, is that women, more times than not, do not enjoy the acts that are portrayed in porn sex. The acts that are in real sex are ones of connection and pleasure and happiness and fulfillment, and it's rounded out. It's multi-dimensional instead of unidimensional in porn for just intensity, mostly for male consumers. So you don't need, nor do you want, to bring the acts that you see in porn sex into real sex. A better way is to communicate with your partner and find out what she or he might be interested in. You want to find out what the real sex partner enjoys. You want to tap into yourself and your self-awareness and discover what you really enjoy, which might be difficult because it's going to be through the lens of what you've been consuming. But the end goal is to realize what your actual arousal template is, what your partner's arousal template is, and get that groove on in real sex. Okay, moving on to number 2, is that in porn scenes, actors get going instantaneously, like that. They're ready. That's not how real sex works. Real sex on average takes 10 to 12 minutes for people to get going. And especially if you live a busy life and you are making time for sex, which most people are kind of squeezing it in even though they want to, it can take even longer if you go from folding laundry or from work to trying to get it on. So give yourself some grace if you can't instantaneously get it going, because on average, it takes 10 to 12 minutes. Now, it also, in pornography, actors can go forever. But in real life, once you get going, it's 3 minutes long. And that's good. That is what real sex is. Real sex isn't going forever. It's not being ready immediately and then being able to go forever. And I'm here to tell you, women don't want to go forever. They want to have that slow building of the arousal and having it culminate in pleasure, happiness, connection, and joy. That's what makes real sex so much better than porn sex. Okay, moving on to number four is that we know that porn sex is an exploitive performance, which is why I have been referring to people who are in porn as performers. They are putting on a performance for you, the fourth wall consumer. You are consuming pornography, which is a performance that involves camera angles and lighting and the exploitation of everybody who's involved. We know from anecdotal and from science that most people who are involved in the pornography industry are being coerced, either overtly or covertly being taken advantage of to be in the pornography industry. Those people are there not because they want to be there, but because it's a performance that they have been exploited into doing for your pleasure, which is the total opposite of real sex, which is a special experience that is shared between two people. Yes, I said two people, because also what the science shows is that polyamory relationships that have more than two people are there for the benefit of one person. So real sex involves two people connecting and sharing themselves to have a real experience. Okay, number five. We know that porn sex increases anxiety and shame. Science proves it. A porn cycle is built on shame in the first place, and it perpetuates shame, which creates anxiety. And it can create depression, moodiness, anger, irritability, brain fog, ADHD. It leads to a whole host of difficulty in terms of cognitive and mental function and psychological function. And it also can result in erectile dysfunction because it is frying out the reward center in your brain, but it leads to anxiety and shame. Real sex, when we realize that evolutionarily we are built to be sexual beings, and evolutionarily it's for procreation, we are meant to be sexual. It's natural. It is the way that it's supposed to be. And you might not have heard that messaging growing up, but I am here to tell you that as you go through your teen years and your 20s and your 30s, you become a sexual being, and that is okay. And that doesn't have shame surrounding it. Shame goes down when you have real sex with a real partner and you enjoy it. Number six, porn sex. Designed for isolation. You, the consumer, are being taken advantage of. The industry knows that it's highly addictive and that it hijacks your brain and that you're consuming it in isolation. And they're taking advantage of the fact that they know that the majority of people go to porn to regulate their mood, to take the edge off of negative feelings. And so you're going into isolation and it's seeming connection. You feel like you're going in there because you're dissociating into fantasy and thinking about yourself as if you were involved in that performance. But in fact, it's dissociation, which means you're leaving your true self. You're disconnecting from your true self. When you have real sex with a real partner and you're enjoying it, it's multidimensional, you now are connecting, which is what we in humanity, it's the number one thing that we want, that we strive for. We want connection. And we know that many people use porn to fill the void of the connection they are not getting. I'm here to tell you, fill the void in a healthy way. Find people to connect with in the real world. It'll lead to intimacy, which is friendship and developing a deeper relationship, which can lead to then a sexual relationship. Number seven, this is a big one. Are you ready for it? Porn is fake. It's not real. The people don't want to be there. None of it is real, which is the total opposite of real sex that you can literally be involved in. Don't spend your life watching fake stuff that is damaging your brain, increasing your shame, increasing your anxiety, and it's not even real. Spend your life doing something that is real with someone you care about in a special experience that feeds your mind, your body, and your spirit and heals your brain, brings your brain online, endorphins get cranking, and it increases your happiness. And what that does is it increases your connection through oxytocin flowing through your brain. You still get pleasure from dopamine, you get happiness from serotonin, and in the end, you are having a beautiful experience. Okay, I hope this helps you out. And what I want you to know is if you keep going back to the screen, it's time to make a change. And we know that a multifaceted program is the way to do it. Many people struggle with leaving pornography behind by themselves. If you're struggling, you are not alone. I built a 90-day program in the nonprofit that I am creating so that you have the tools that you need to succeed, to leave it behind forever, and get yourself into a beautiful, real sexual relationship that you can enjoy and thrive in for the rest of your life. I'm here for you if you're interested in that. It's a digital program, and then you can add a group with me so I can personally help you through the journey. I'd love to do it. I'd be honored to do it if it feels good. Reach out to me at drtrishleigh.com if it's something that interests you. And in the meantime, control your brain or it will control you.